two households, both alike in dignity. In fair Verona, where we lay our scene, from ancient grudge break to new mutiny, where civil blood makes civil hands unclean. From forth the fatal loins of these two foes, a pair of star-crossed lovers take their life, whose misadventured, piteous overthrows do with their death bury their parents' strife. The fearful passage of their death-marked love and the continuance of their parents' rage, which, but for their children's end, naught could remove, is now the two-hour traffic of our stage. The which, if you with patient ears attend, what here shall miss, our toil shall strive to mend. If we shadows have offended, think but this, and all is mended, that you have but slumbered here while these visions did appear, and this weak and idle theme no more yielding but a dream. Gentles, do not reprehend. If you pardon, we will mend. And as I am an honest park, if we have unearned luck now to scape the serpent's tongue, we will make amends ere long, else the puck a liar call. So, good night unto you all. Give me your hands if we be friends, and Robin will restore amends. Thus far, with rough and all unable pen, our bending author hath pursued the story. In little room, confining mighty men, mangling by starts the full course of their glory. Small time, but in that small, most greatly lived this star of England. Fortune made his sword, by which the world's best garden he achieved, and of it left his son, imperial lord, Henry the Sixth, in infant bands, crowned king of France and England, did this king succeed, whose state so many had the managing that they lost France and made his England bleed, which oft our stage hath shown, and for their sake, in your fair minds, let this acceptance take.